Remember your sixth grade classroom? Did you have solar panels? How about a weather station? Well, students in Salem will get both because of a grant. News for Utah's Sarah Martin spent the day in Mrs. Elliott's class to see how these sixth graders do STEM.
What is your plan? Walk me through the plan.
Her students start out making paper bridges. The longest and the strongest win some candy.
I think the kids love it. It really makes them love science.
Mrs. Elliott and her students do all kinds of projects, from bridges to hand warmers to scribble bots. But she's always looking for ways to push them even further.
I was really looking for materials that would help our students understand the greenhouse effect and climate change and adaptation. And so when I saw this grant, I'm like, oh, this is a great opportunity.
The Society of Science and the public gave $100,000 to teachers for STEM equipment this year. Mrs. Elliott was awarded $3,000.
And we hope that confidence that it builds will hopefully propel some of these students into college and perhaps even some majors and careers eventually.
Her class will get to go on a field trip to Leonardo, funding for science fair projects, plus some pretty amazing classroom technology.
We asked for some greenhouse kits and some solar cell kits because I think it's fun for them to learn how solar cell, they see lots of solar panels going up on houses, and how does that work? And what would that really mean if we could put a solar panel on every house in America?
All of this by simply applying for a grant.
A lot of grants go unused, partly because it is time consuming. You know, for me, it took a couple weeks in the summertime, but for me, it was worth it. It was worth the time that it took to make sure that the students in our school could have access to those materials. Most of the kids, when they get here, they do not love science. They really don't love math. And by the end of the year, most of them are like, oh, I can't wait to have science next year.
Reporting from Salem, I'm Sarah Martin, News 4 Utah.